Today, I will explain you how CT scan change my technique for rhinoplasty. And I will explain you on this nose. So this is the pictures before rhinoplasty. As you can see, there is a slight deviation, but it seems like not so difficult nose. When I saw this nose, I thought, okay, I can use preservation osteotomy, maybe push down, maybe let down, polygon tip plasty, and I thought that it will just 2 hours of surgery. Now I can show you result 1 year after the rhinoplasty. So finally, everything is okay. You can see the beautiful lights, the beautiful shadows. Nose is more straight. It has natural lines, the good profile view. But this nose was very, very interesting. Why? Look on the screen. So again, we can compare before and after. Before and after. Before and after. Seems easy case. So my idea was to use classical preservation rhinoplasty. For example, here, push down rhinoplasty with the high strip. But then I saw the CT scan of the patient. And on the CT scan of this patient, what we can see? We can see the huge deviation of the septum. So septum is deviated to the left side. It's tilted to the left side and also blocked the left side of the nose totally. This deviation was the birth of the patient, so all her life she breathed like normally well and she didn't know that she can breathe better. But these pictures, these CT scans are very important to understand that previous technique that I tell you before will be not useful for this case. Or if for with this deviation, with this asymmetry of the septum, you can have huge complication if you will use classical preservation osteotomy. Why? Because this shape of the septum will move your pyramid after preservation osteotomy. So, yes, at the end of the surgery, it can be like straight, but then because of the swelling of the mucosa inside, because of the septum, also because of the swelling of the mucosa under the bones, this deviation will push this pyramid to the left side. Also, you can see that she has chronic sinuses on the left side. From this picture also, you can see that we don't have only the deviated septum. We have the nasal spur deep inside of the nose. On the 3D view, it seems like normal bones, like it's not the S-shaped bone, it's straight bone, so nothing special from the side view. But from the face view, we can see a lot of asymmetries. First of all, we can see the asymmetry of the skull base. We can see the asymmetry of the bones. And it is important to know and to understand for the patient, for the surgeons before the surgery, that you cannot change a lot the bone. Yes, you can cut the bone, you can move the parts of the bone, but you cannot make big changes. You can make it more symmetrical using the special technique, but you cannot do big changes because also this bone is very, very thin and you can have the holes inside if you will drill it or you will try to rasp a lot of this bone. So we can see that we have the asymmetry of the bony part of the septum, we have deviation asymmetry of the nasal bones. So I was focused, first of all, on these asymmetries, on the tilted part of the nasal pyramid. And I understood before that I need to correct this bony part of the septum inside. And here is the video of the nose before the surgery. I reconstruct the nose. Here I can show you how the bones looks like before the surgery, the shape of the tip cartilages, and also you can see the deviation of the septum. You see the position of the septum. And now I can show you, also you can analyze the shape of the septum, the position of the septum without tip cartilages. It can be more understandable for you. And this is an example why the classical osteotomy will be not a good choice for this patient. Because if you will open the roof, if you will rasp the roof, this deviation will be more visible after the surgery. Because you will close all the structure together and then this deviation will be visible after the surgery. So what I did, I used this technique. So I moved totally the septum, I moved the bones, so to correct such huge deviation, to correct crooked noses, you need to use this technique. You need to move the septum, you need to move all the bones, so all the structures together, because it's like a one big structure. Also here you have the upper lateral cartilages. It is very, very important. And from the side view, this technique looks like this. Also, CT scan and the modeling of the bones by the CT scan, we can know before the surgery how we need to move the bone to have especially those shape that we want to have after the surgery. Because we can calculate everything, we will measure everything, and then we can see the final shape of the nose when we will make the movement of the bone. So we can prognose before the movement of the bone, and we know how we need to move, what we need to do before the surgery. So the plan of the surgery was to cut the septum, then to cut the dorsum like this, to make these cuts, to disconnect upper lateral cartilages from the bone, to rasp a little bit the highest part of the roof of the dorsum, then to cut the upper lateral cartilage, to change the anterior part of upper lateral cartilages. Here it was double osteotomy, and then to move totally the septum and to make like a two parts of the septum. And this is the final result of our nose. So it was the face view, that how our nose looks like before the surgery, and our final result after the surgery. You can see the polygon shape of the tips, you can see the columellar strut, the rim grafts, also you can see the position of the bones, but the most important information for you will be how I fix the dorsum. So this is the shape of the nose after the surgery. And this is the 3D modeling of the nose. So what I did, I moved the septum totally. Then I make like a two parts of the septum and I fix these two parts together. That's how I stabilized the septum. And this is the ultrasound control of our position of the bone, so there is no steps, all the bones connected to each other. So this is an example how CT scan helps us to know which technique we need to use before the surgery, to choose the correct technique before the surgery. Because without the CT scan, it could be a lot of complications. But we have beautiful nose and we have beautiful result. I hope this information was useful for you. I will try to make more videos like this to explain you more about rhinoplasty, about facelift, eyelid surgeries, haloplasty, also breast augmentation. And don't forget that I have my Telegram channel. On my Telegram channel, here will be the link, you will find all these videos so you can look them much more time. Thank you very much. Bye.